You say we're live? Hello and welcome everyone to another match of the Osu Malaysia Mania Tournament, third iteration. I'm your commentator, Razors, and I'm joined by one of our hosts, Louis Football.
Hello, hello.
Damn. Yeah, how are you doing?
I just had my dinner.
Ooh, nice. That's good to know.
Yes, very, very nice. Very good food, now also in good mood to come.
Hell yeah. And this is indeed a match to look forward to for most people. Tosai, seed 2. Going up against Mina.
I guess. Yeah, Mina, Mina, apa-apa lah.
Which is seed 7. Coming out of the qualifiers. Tosai, so far, both players have sweeped their round 32 match, but it seems like Mina was the one that had to really go in deep for his round 16 match, having to use the tiebreaker to clutch it out to stay in the winning bracket.
Yeah, like him going to tiebreaker actually came as a little bit of a surprise to me. Because like, with his rank, I thought like, okay, this level of net pool is it shouldn't really be that much of an issue, but it looks like his opponent also seems to be really proficient in this level, so ended up with tiebreaker with Marina just edging it out, and now he is in the winner's bracket now going up against Tosai.
Yeah, he certainly has to step it up. Hopefully last week was just a fluke, or I guess you could say the map pool was easier, so his opponent could come, I mean, what's the word, should like combat him.
Yeah, it's an easier pool, so there's less skill cap to be had, and his opponent just also very comfortable with that level.
Yeah. This time though, he's going up against Tosai, who has been pretty much demolishing through the brackets so far.
Yeah, Tosai, even though his 4K rank is actually lower than Marina, with like Tosai being closer to 4 digit at like 800 something, Marina is like 300 something. So, but yeah, Tosai, he does have very good at game. He can ratio a lot of stuff pretty well, even though he's hidden player, and not a lot of hidden players can do that. Marina, he might be able to handle harder stuff a little bit easier, have a little bit of an easier time compared to Tosai. But with this round, quarterfinals, it's a little bit of like the in between. You might see points go back and forth, but I'm not too sure.
Yeah, we'll just have to see if Tosai could bring out his monster scores once again in this matchup against Marina. Yeah, looking at his qualifier scores, right? Almost, he has never gotten the placing below 5th. That is... okay. That's kind of scary. Especially if you're Marina. His weakest links, just based on the qualifier's map pool alone, seems to be Vice 1. So that's gonna be a bit of an issue considering how many Vice maps we have in the pool.
Okay, I don't know how this slipped past, but the first map in qualifiers is actually SV, so actually just seeing it right now, it's all wrong.
Oh shit. I see.
Alright, big oops.
Little oopsie there, but in that case though, that's the two SV maps for him to worry about, but he can take one out in the ban phase, so that should be fine.
Yeah, but leaving in one SB is pretty much a guaranteed point for Tosai.
At least it's just one, not 6.
Oh yeah, for real.
For real. But still, Marina has his work cut out for him, as this might seem to be a ratio battle, just as with Apple's opponents had to face.
Okay, Apple being seed one, I think the really, really big difference is that Apple is a seasoned MWC player. He's known as one of the best rise, best act player in 4K for Malaysia. And he's here, and everyone else, like, these are names that I have seen in like 4-digit MWC, and that's pretty much it. I'm not too sure whether like the top 5 has ever been in actual MWC before.
And yeah, the experience that you mentioned in for Apple being in MWC before certainly helps a lot in this tournament. Given pretty much almost half the field is just new players.
Oh, okay. We're right into the final quarter of the first warm-up.
Easy. Wow, Tosai, gonna be warming up? I'm assuming this is warm-up, so gonna be warming up with long notes. Okay. He's prepared playing long notes with Dylan. It's just how does anyone do this? It's beyond me.
Yeah, well, him being hidden main, it's pretty clear cut to see that he will be playing most, if not all, of the maps with hidden, except for SB, because that's just how he is.
Yeah, the only player probably in this tournament to use hidden unironically. Oh. Yeah, there goes the size warm up.
Wait, actually, this Akasha, no wait, this is Marina's warm up.
Right. Okay, so that's interesting. He did hold his combo quite well, I think.
We didn't really get to see the first three quarters of the warm-up because it's a big file to download. It's like 81 MB because it's like it's just a map collection all in one map set.
No wonder. This makes sense, but yeah, this will be Tosai's warm-up and it seems like gonna be another long no map. Okay, both these players.
Yeah, Ellen. I know Tosai is also very good at Ellen. Probably one of the second best next to Apple, at least in this tournament.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if that's the case.
But actually, in qualifiers, yeah, Tosai did get first seed, but that is with the qualified difficulty. I assume that when the difficulty picks up in the following rounds, we will start to see Apple being a little bit more proficient at handling really, really difficult LN's patterns. But for now, enough about Apple. We have to go back to Tosai and Marina.
Yeah, given both these players warm ups, it seems like we will have a very intense matchup in the long note pool this time. Why not even entertaining the hidden coming from Tosai is gonna oblige just to see what it feels like to play long notes with hidden. Which he's not faring too bad, but against Tosai, currently is just you can see there's a clear gap.
Yeah, the thing with hidden is that it doesn't really it doesn't really make things hard or easier, but you will find yourself like hitting a lot more bad judgments, like 200s at 100s, because you're just not used to the playfield being like half closed. So you start to like try to estimate like where the receptor is, and also with a hidden in stable actually not being too nice, I don't really like how hidden works in stable. Like, you start it starts like covering 25% of the play screen, but then as when your combo is rising, so does the covered portion. And then you miss, goes all the way back down. That's very distracting.
Yeah, it functions a bit like the flashlight mod in the standard.
Yeah, exactly like that.
I can see why it can be jarring, especially when you get into the harder maps where you don't have time, like you are 100% focused on, you know, where the black bar is, and you're just looking at that bar, and suddenly you find a miss, and your vision just expands.
Yeah. I was wondering whether that was my internet or what.
Yeah, me too. Okay. All good. As the second one is about to come to an end, Tosai holding onto a 3k combo. That's insane.
Yeah, I think that was FT.
I thought I saw him break once. Maybe I'm wrong.
Also with Mania, when you drop a long note in the middle, it doesn't actually count as a miss. It just counts as a 50.
Makes sense. And right away, the players will be doing their roles. And Miner coming up strong this time. 46 points against Tosai's 27 points.
Yeah, winning the role is already winning half the battle.
Yes, the other half is to just beat Tosai. C2,
yes,
surely.
Yeah, for sure.
No big deal, man. No sweat. No pressure at all. And that will mean Miner will be starting this off with one Protect of his. And yeah, given his comments in the server, and from what I've seen, it seems like he's kind of just chilling and maybe even sight reading some, if not most, of these maps.
Yeah, hard to say. Does he? I mean, he's protecting SB1. Maybe he's okay, but still, he's going up against Tosai, who is also very, very good at SB.
Well, I mean, at this point, you kind of just have to go with whatever advantage you can find or whatever map that you feel like could catch your opponent off, and often that might be the case. SB might be the case for most of these under, like, lower seed players to try to get a point.
Yeah, if it was any other player except Tosai, I would say maybe, yeah, that could work. But with Tosai also being a player who does grind out SB, grinds out their combos, trying to get the timing, he puts work into SBs.
Okay, never mind then. As you can see, Tosai is gonna protect the other SB, so the entire SB pool will probably be played in this match, along with the two. Oh boy. I mean, our second attack will be just Rise 4, understandable, and his ban will be Rise 2, which is Jump Streams, okay.
Oh, why do you have to ban Rise 2? That's a good song.
Should have banned Rise 1, no cap.
For real.
You know, Tosai, interesting ban, gonna take out the hybrid one, and oh, wowzers. Okay, never mind, it's Tosai's pick. And
yeah,
immediately.
It is his pick, so I'm just going to predict the score. It's going to be like at least 985k versus I want to say like maybe 750k.
Oh, I can see that happening, especially if Mina hasn't exactly put in much practice in this SV.
Like, one of the main reasons I say that is because, like, in the chat, like, Mina's already expressing very much dislike for the fact that SV2 was protected.
Okay, true. We'll just have to see how it goes as we head into the first map of this match, being SV2, and right off the bat, we'll see a 200 drop. Oh, and a fake! This is... I think you are on the money here with that prediction.
It could still be wrong. Tosai might not get 985k. He might get like 990k. What's the difference? It's just 5,000. It's fine. It's close enough.
Yeah. We make do. See, head to the first section here, and Mina obviously already massively in the back foot. Yeah, this guy's a side eating this. There's no way. His accuracy down to a dismal 91.
Yeah, he's just trying to get some semblance of timing. Like, he does hit the nose, but it's just not accurate enough. And Tosai is finally out of 990k range and picks up a 200. That sends him down a little bit more. But in terms of, like, score difference, that's just not going to matter.
Yeah, that is true. The egg difference alone is just too wide, man. Even if Tosai finds a couple of bigs, it wouldn't matter too much. I doubt Mina can climb back his combo much. And yeah, there you have it. Another break coming up from him. And one thing of note though, seems surprising that Tosai is not rolling with hidden for SV. Maybe he doesn't want to risk it.
Yeah, he plays SVs for everything except... he plays hidden for everything except SV. That's what I
mean. Ah, I see. Oh, yeah,
yeah,
you're gonna see.
Because the scroll speed is like fluctuating so much, and with hidden is just too risky. For all we know, like a really dense SV section will happen where you can't see it.
Yeah, that is true. That does make sense. And we'll see Tosai taking his first point very convincing, as you have predicted, 988k versus 721k.
It's close enough.
Yeah, it is certainly just about close enough. This time, gonna pass the pick to Mina now. Let's see what it's gonna be a hybrid 2.
Yeah, hybrid 2. Although he wanted to go with hybrid 1 first, but you can't pick a bad map.
Yeah, unfortunate. We should make a rule for that.
Yeah, I think we should.
The protect ban protect system. The Uno reverse. Players get one chance to unban the map.
Real.
Yeah, it seems like Mina is certainly gravitating towards the long notes. The long note maps, I mean. He's gonna start off with a hybrid first to test the waters, see if he's feeling it with this hybrid too.
Yeah, at least if you're going to go hybrid, pick something that is a little bit more towards your comfort, like, not entirely, but yeah, it's there. Because this is the long note focus hybrid.
Yeah, and we do see, as you have mentioned, Tosai bringing out his hidden. Let's see what he can pull off. In the intro here, Mina dropping a bit of accuracy down to 99.5. Not too shabby, but against Tosai, who just dropped out of 99.9. And 99.8, never mind, he's dropping a bit.
Okay, picks up a couple 200 there as well. I think Mina actually managed to hold on. The only 200 he got was from the very first note.
Yeah, that's a certified classic. given he probably hasn't really played this pool much. There you go.
Bridge come in the mini hand jack section.
But thankfully for Mina, he still has his accuracy intact for the most part.
Yeah, it's a relatively clean break. It's like just a miss and no other bad judgment. It's just one miss and that's it. So yeah, you can still hold some accuracy, but not with that though. Another miss is pretty much going to be reducing his chances a whole lot.
Meanwhile, Leon just being chilling with 99.7. This guy is there's only a quarter of the map left, and it doesn't seem like he's breaking anytime soon. While Miners
on the other hand, breaks left and right.
Yeah, unfortunately, it seems like Vina has tested the waters, and this hybrid 2 is lethal for him.
Yeah, the waters were too rough.
Yeah, he didn't realize there was a Kraken. And there's Tosai with that monstrous 991k.
Yeah, he's just like pretty good at the game.
Who is this player? Check him PC.
He's a good player, but this is not normally.
And of course, Leon gonna oblige to another long note. Well, I guess, yeah, it's a long note pick. Long note 2. Seems to be a favorite among the players so far.
Not for Mayina, though.
He is very vocal about the things he hates. 10 things he hates about this rat pool.
Obviously, the best solution is to just play with music volume at 0.
Ah, that is true.
You could do that and also replace the audio with something else.
Like what?
I don't know. Like literally anything. Like you could put I don't know, donkeys being electrocuted underwater, and to him it probably sound pretty okay.
Alright, sure. As we get into through the intro now, Mina holding on pretty well, as with the hybrid 2 that we have just seen just a tad bit below. Tosai was onto a 9.9 soon.
It's just a matter of time before Tosai gets back up.
Oh, but
In that meantime, though, Mina is not going to go back to that 99.7 anytime soon.
Yeah. Oh, Tosai, come on. He's trying so hard. But it's just not happening. He keeps getting those standard 300s every once in a while.
Long notes are actually particularly very tricky to get a good ratio on, because you're not just focusing on the start of the LM, but you also have to time the releases properly, because those come for 2 judgments.
Yeah, which is what makes long notes a pretty niche skill set per se, especially for the less any ones that's not top player.
Yeah, understandable.
As we see Tosai dropping to a low 99.8 now.
Which, don't get me wrong, it's still really, really good. That is definitely above 990k score.
Yeah.
Provided he doesn't miss.
Yes. Surely. But at the end of the map, there's no more parts for him to miss. Is Mina gonna pick up a couple of hundreds on his way out?
But he does still finish off in 980k, pretty respectable score. Only 6 200s though, actually. Wow, okay. At least just 6200s is like also really, really good. But Tosai is just on another level with just 3200s.
I think he also got 3200s like last map. I'm pretty
sure. Yeah, he did.
Wow. Insane score coming up from Tosai. Wonder if we'll be able to see a V1 SS coming up from him in this match.
Okay, now I'm pretty sure that Marina did not... It is like going to sight reading the entire pool, does not see... Like, I don't think he even looked at the main sheet, because it does say what kind of map is what. Like, Rise 1 is definitely not Jax. That will be Rise 5.
But it's in for surprise.
Like, imagine if, like, some... but I know for standard players, they have, like, different skins based on what kind of a map it is, or, like, what mod. Like, they have skins for DT, skins for Hard Rock. Imagine if you have, like, different skins for different kinds of mania patterns. Like, oh, Jackman, I'm going to use this skin. Oh, Ellens, I'm going to change to this skin. Imagine if he has a skin for Jack, and then this happens.
Yeah, I can already see it happening. We'll just see what Marina can pull off when he's faced with Stamina without any precautions. As he heads into the longest map in the pool, 4 minutes 37 seconds.
Yeah, also with this being consistency, honestly, it's not that bad. Because, like, it's very... Like the type of the Rise... It just confirms that it's consistency. So you're just going to be hitting roughly the same patterns for a very long time. You just need to keep good focus throughout the entire map, and you pretty much have a decent score. And these two players, I think they can do just that.
But the problem is, though, for Marina, like, I don't know his playstyle, but will he just use all of his strength in, like, the first half and then just totally break down in the second half, not knowing how long this map is?
Yeah, there's definitely a possibility for that. I've had that happen to me a couple of times before. Normally, I try to avoid Rise maps that are very long and also very consistent, much like this one. Unless the map has like a considerably decently long break section where I can regain my stamina. This part right here, it's not bad. It's quite easy. It's just like regular, just a regular 2-3 note chords. It's not streams of any kind. So yeah, this is the part where you use to get your stamina back.
That's true. Tosai is still onto a 99.94. Maybe not a bit behind, but both players have their combos intact, so anything can still happen. We are halfway through the map. Marina so far still holding on.
Yeah, halfway through here. The ratio game is strong in Tosai's favor. Here comes the first burst rolls. Both of them hitting them. Both of them at least still maintaining their V1 double S. Only thing right now separating both of these players is 0.07%. It purely comes from ratio.
Yeah, Miners still coping, holding on, trying to not let Tosai get away with this. Tosai slowly dropping a bit of accuracy.
Oh,
and a break! That might be huge!
Two-thirds of the map, Marina can hold on, then this is probably going to be his point.
Yeah, with a side lead. There's no way. Oh my god, there's no way.
Until Tosai gets that up to 400 combo, that lead will continue to grow, and now with him right now being at 500, he needs to hold on, and Marina needs to drop more accuracy. It's still like about, I don't know how long of the map is left, maybe like 30-40 seconds. But yeah, if Marina holds on, it is going to be his point.
Let's see the final few patterns, and he does nail that.
Oh, I think Marina picked up the 200.
Still not enough. What to say? Steal it back.
Score difference of about 2,000 points. This song might sound like it's hitting the outro, but if you look at the score, 900k to both players, there's still a little bit of map left.
Yeah, we'll see if Miner can hit the landing.
Miner hits another 200. It's getting really close, but I don't think there's enough time anymore. It's got to be a full combo for Miner to take the win.
Oh my,
the final burst.
Oh my god.
And he holds on.
We found another 200 right at the very end. Thankfully, that did not result in a break. What the hell, this guy? Who needs ratio when you can just have your opponent miss once?
And he seems to be very excited for that, but is immediately taken down a notch with the LN1 pick by Tosai.
Yes, Tosai not gonna let Miner revel in that point that he just got from him by dragging him into the depths of Long Note again, this time being Long Note 1. Which I think unfortunately will be muted. Unless I do a cover or something.
I don't either.
I'm just gonna try and talk over it.
Alright, it's okay. Yeah. We're just waiting for the MP start to happen. And here we go. Time for map number 5. Yowasobi Shukufuku. And as usual, once again, Tosai with the hidden. But that is to be expected. We'll see if Marina will be able to maintain his momentum after picking up his first point. So will he be able to hold on? Seems to be rather equal right out the gate.
Yeah, Marina does have to be careful though. This long note one tests more on the coordination, so these long note release patterns can be devilish.
Yeah, 200s are going to be a norm in this map. As you can see, both players are already below that 99.7 mark, with Marina going down all the way to 99.5. The distance, the score gap is still quite minimal though. A break or a couple of rush of 200s will swing the lead over if Tosai is not careful.
Yeah, we did see Marina getting 2 200s there right before I handed into the first key eye here, and another one.
Yeah, another one there. Oh, but actually Tosai builds his way back up to 99.7, so right now looks to be pretty comfortable for him. That's already like whole 3.5% or 0.35% lead for Tosai in accuracy. And this map, it does not line up with the releases. It is just going to be 200s best. Left and right, Marina picks up another couple of 200s, and that lead is just going to be stagnating over for Tosai with a gap of at least like 4 to 5k.
However, again, Marina still not out of the picture, although he is picking up a few more 200s than his opponent. As long as he holds onto his combo and doesn't drop too much accuracy, he still has a chance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tosai picks up another 200, but yeah, as you said, both players are also still on the FC. A little bit of a breakdown. Going back into the next PI, we will see a repeat of the earlier PIs. Tosai picks up another couple of 200, but Marina's accuracy is not near enough for it to count. And he also continued to pick up a couple of 200s for himself. We might see two full combos, but in the end, Tosai with the better accuracy might still be in his favor though. Although there is still quite a fair bit of map left. I would imagine that both these players who have already comboed all the way here, I don't think they will have that much problem hitting the rest of the map.
Yeah, Marina certainly needs Tosai to have a very messy break right now, but we are heading into the dying stages of this map and it just doesn't seem like that's happening for Tosai. As he will get his fourth point.
A double full combo, but yeah, Tosai with 99.6 to minus 99.2, and like with Tosai having half of minus regular 300 count, it's pretty good at the game.
That is true, and that's also a trend I've been noticing. Tosai, especially his 200s, always seem to be like exactly half of his opponent of Maina's.
Good act player be like.
The visual game is real in this one, very strong. Oh, Maina, you just
okay,
look at cheats, man.
Maina, if you want the Jack Map, pick Rise 5.
How?
Like, real.
Real. No, pick Tiebreaker, come on.
Of course. Yo, he's doing it. He's doing the Rise 5. I swear, we do not have influence over the picks.
Yeah, surely. It's not like the players said they are going to look at the stream.
Of course, players, they're not going to look at the stream. They need to focus on their match. They don't need to listen to commentators accidentally cursing people.
Yeah, definitely. What is Maina on about in the chat? I don't get it.
Well, I mean, one can only wonder.
Yes, one can only wonder what is going through his mind as he sees Rise 5 get played.
Also, best song in the pool next to Rise 2, which was unfortunately killed.
Okay, true. I can see that. And oh my god, Tosai. I know it's very early on, but that accuracy.
I know.
Jesus. Someone's pulling a 99.95 and above, you know he's confident.
Yeah, he do be like that. In fact, I think the only regular 300 that he's getting is coming from LN. Like, we see everything else. Okay, well, there's a couple, but oh, actually, oh. The ratio game right now is actually really equal, though.
Yeah,
both of them 99.9, 99.91, 99.9 flat.
First Ki, and we are already halfway through the map. Maina trying his best to take this. Gonna be close. Not the players seem like they're letting up.
Yeah, it is very close. Look at the difference at look at the score difference right now. There's barely anything. Maina seems to be coming out on top a little bit, but there's still some map left. But it's just gonna be flickering back and forth all the way until the end. With both players at 99.92.
Oh,
emerge on top. We could be seeing score difference less than 100 points.
And then that's certainly possible. What, 200?
Oh, Maina, 99.93. He picks up a little bit. Will he be able to hold on to that?
Oh, and he does!
Yo, he
holy
does.
200. Oh. That is
Just over 100 points. And that is 4 regular 300s of difference. B1SS for both players.
For the first time, well, not exactly, but for in a scenario where both players have SSs, V1SSs, for the first time, Marina are gonna ratio Tosai instead, and this vice 5.
Well, but it's okay. It's just another point. It's just couple of regular 300s. You just like put that behind you.
Yeah.
Just go with what your opponent really does not like.
Does like
into the SV.
Yeah, it's deciding to switch it up this time. Not gonna just pull out the Donald tree just yet. He knows Marina didn't like that SV2 one bit, and given that he publicly declared multiple times he is sight reading this. Yeah.
Well, at least lucky for him that this is more reading focused. You don't really need to put too much effort into memorizing compared to SV2. For this one, you can get by with considerably less practice.
Still, a few 200s dropped by Marina already in the first quarter. Not gonna do him any good. He's now down to a dismal 98. Looking to drop even further below.
Yeah, but if it's like this, I would say that it will be like, again, 988k to maybe 900k this time.
I'm gonna be so sure. But we'll see. Marina continues to pick up a lot of 200s in this section.
Okay, Marina is actually hitting a lot of notes really late. And that sudden slowdown actually makes him hit too early. He's both too early and too late. There's something that's really hard to fix in the SV map.
Yeah, at this point he's just trying to combo game. There's nothing else left. He's getting 200s, almost like at least 10 out of 50, 300s. As the map comes to a close, Tosai is going to close it out about
99.5, 982k. Okay, this is the score for this SV1 is actually closer with my prediction for SV2, 980k to like 750k. You actually see it here in SV1 instead of SV2.
You put your prediction on the wrong SV.
I flipped the script accidentally.
Bro, make sure to read it the right side up.
Sorry, I'm dyslexic.
No way. With that SV1 win, convincingly, Tosai gonna secure himself match point. And, well, even though it's still minus pick, so he could still get one more point before, you know, Tosai puts him out of his misery in this match.
And yeah, with both of minus points coming from rice map, so going based on the trend, yeah, Marina does have a good chance on this as well. But after this, Tosai has like hybrid tree and also LN tree to like hopefully close out the game. But yeah, first we're gonna have to go through rice 6 to see what the outcome will be.
Yeah, this Y6, if I remember correctly, is like a mix of everything.
Yeah, there's a lot. There's a lot of different kinds of patterns that you will find in the different rice picks for this round. We do see some jacks, we do see some technical stuff happening. So yeah, it's mixed. Like this part in the middle here, it does focus a little bit on jacks, but now 400 combo, we see the shift in the patternings a little bit.
Tosai, despite the slow start early on, he is catching up to Marina.
Oh, and once again, we are equal. We are seeing the same thing as Rush 5. We have the same accuracy. But this is only a quarter of the way through. There's still a lot of map left for things to go horribly wrong for one of them.
it's true. But given the outcomes of the previous two Vice maps that we have seen in this match, it seems highly unlikely, let's just say.
Yeah.
Wainan is gonna pull away slightly from Tosai with his accuracy now up for a moment up to 99.9.
Yeah, Wainan has been building a little bit, but Tosai is unfortunately the one that's actually falling a little bit short.
Yeah, Tosai, all things considered, he's still keeping his combo alive.
Yeah, for sure. That is his one saving grace. He's gonna have to hope for Mina to suddenly find a rush of 200, or even better for Tosai would be a break. Because this map, it does also have quite some choke heavy patterns. You see here, there's some mini jacks happening, where mini jacks. A lot of people would consider something that you could easily choke on. So far for these two players, they're just keeping it cool. They're still holding on to all their combos.
It seems like Mainaz is a natural with the Vice picks. Still holding on to a 99.89.
Yeah, looks like accuracy is going to be minor saving grace here. Tosai, he's doing his best to try and catch up. Going back up to 99.83, but he's pretty much just stagnating there. A lot of the patterns of... this one particular pattern, this stream burst here, just gave him a miss. So it does look like Marina is going to be comfortably taking this one after like a very hard-fought battle for the first 80% of the map.
Yeah, seems like Vice, Tosai just couldn't really etch out the extra mile to beat Maena. But this might very well be the last point Maena is gonna get in this match. So you pulled out a very respectable 996k.
Actually, a V1 double S, and also surprisingly, even better ratio than Tosai, something that we've not seen throughout the entire match. It was just Tosai out-acking Mina for like, I don't know, for the longest time, but suddenly Rysix comes and yeah.
Oh, yeah. Surprise, surprise! Tosai gonna clean out the long note pool with a long note 3 pick. If the outcome of the previous two long note maps played were to be believed, Tosai has won this match.
Yeah, I would imagine so as well. Unless, like, the only way I can see Marina taking this point is if Tosai misses and Marina doesn't. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, that's indeed probably the only possibility that Marina's gonna take this.
And here we go, potentially the final map that we're gonna see played for this match.
And Mina, Mirror and Hidden?
Okay.
What's this guy smoking?
Okay, he's trolling.
He says, you know what, I'm just gonna become my opponent. Why the hell not?
Yeah, I'll become my opponent and also be a little extra with Mirror.
Yes, since I'm sight reading anyway, it doesn't hurt me.
Yeah, we can hear, ladies and gentlemen, here we see the difference of a hidden main and a non-hidden main.
Yeah.
Over on the left side, we have the player, the hidden main in their natural habitat. They're just doing as they do. But on the right side, we have someone like wondering what it's like to play with Hidden.
Yes, for the first time. And not working out very well. To put
although
it nicely.
Props to him though, for he is still keeping that full combo going. But yeah, accuracy is a whole nother story.
I mean, in any case though, it's not out of the woods yet for Tosai. If he finds a break, like right before a quarter of the map left, there is some hope for Mainland to take this. Albeit very unlikely.
Yeah, I would say it's very unlikely because it would definitely take more than one miss. Like, just one miss, it won't really shift the playing field that much. It's going to be have to, like, a full-on lag for half a second.
He would totally need Tosai to just out at four.
Yeah. Because like, I want to say, like, if you miss right now, you would lose out maybe 5,000 points. Maybe closer to 10,000. And just based on the score gap right now, which is about 20,000. We do still see both players only the full combo after 3,000 combo, and the gap is actually extended to closer to like 25,000 points in favor of Tosai. And with the map seeing its final moments, I think it is GGWP.
Yeah, Mainland will be seeing his final moments as well in this match, as Tosai will close this out with this long note tree. 985k, not too shabby for a long note.
Not shabby at all. Actually, this is a really, really insane score.
Yeah, still props to Mainland for holding on the entire way through. Accuracy, let's just not talk about that.
Full combo with Hidden, something that's out of their comfort zone. Yeah, and still managing to hold that full combo. It's commendable.
Yep, that will be it for this match. GG's to both players, but it will be Tosai that wins this match and advances further into the winner's bracket, where he will face against the winner between Jay Lai and Chiyoki 29. Meanwhile, Maina gonna drop down to the loser's bracket. He's gonna face, I don't think we know yet, winner between Purple Loon, I believe, and
Purple Loon and Red Cats.
Oh, Red Cats, yeah. And even though that is it for this match, we still have two matches tonight. One happening in 10 minutes between Lloyd TTG going up against Aleppy, and another one at 11 PM local time between 991-1949.
Yeah, just say like 991.
Yes, I love Mania players names. And do we have any Chirinos? Yeah, I believe we will have to stop stream to archive this for, you know, archive purposes. So we'll see you very soon. Just 10 minutes until the next match. I will probably still be here. And thank you, Rockon, for streaming. Who's that? Thank you, Yubi. Oh, no, wait, shit. Thank you, Ox.
It's Ox.
How do you pronounce his name? Ox?
Ox. Just like, okay. Ox, like the Ox cable.
I see. Thank you, Ox, for rapping. And of course, thank you, Gumifumo, for commentating with me.
No problem.
We'll see you, very soon.
Yeah, we'll see you in 10 minutes.